Woman, by being alert and consistently resorting to self-examination, can detect a lump in the breast before it grows to alarming proportions. Breast examination, as we have said earlier, has saved countless thousands of lives. One British cancer specialist hinted that women might do well to discontinue wearing tight-fitting brassieres, telling further that the abnormal pressure on the breast tissue could prevent normal cell division when necessary, a function known to students in biology as mitosis. Mitosis means cell division. In the self-examination procedure, the woman is often the first to discover a lump in her breast. If she makes such a discovery, it is important for her to go to a doctor immediately. Only after a special examination of a sample tissue can the doctor decide whether the lump is malignant, cancerous, dangerous, or benign, innocent, harmless. This special examination, performed by a specialist known as a biopsy, requires the removal of a small piece of living tissue. The discovery of this lump, if cancerous, dangerous, before it spreads to other parts of the body, increases the chances of the patient's recovery. Therefore, the whole purpose of this presentation, written by a distinguished professor of medicine, is to urge women to administer a self-examination of the breasts as prescribed in this work and in the accompanying simple sketches. Unfortunately, however, most women fail to conduct self-examination of the breasts. Now, there are several reasons, among which are being afraid, too modest, too blasé, too superior, or just simply ignorant. In fact, we live in a society in Britain and Canada and in the United States populated by millions of women who do not even bother about a monthly general medical checkup. This sadly too often means that the tumor on the breast may not be discovered until the cancer has spread to other parts of the body. The breasts are easy to examine. It is therefore a simple matter to detect tumors by feeling for them. The United Kingdom Cancer Society and the West German Cancer Society urges every woman to examine her breast regularly at the end of each menstrual period. The first sign of breast cancer is a lump which, according to medical societies, is painless. But it is a warning signal, and there is no sure way a woman can tell whether the lump is harmless or a threat to her life. Only a doctor can. To wait for signs of cancer is to invite disaster. So we repeat, a lump in the breast is only one sign of what could be cancer. Women who examine their breasts should be on the alert for any irregular contour or shape of the skin or surface shape of the breasts, and to watch for an obvious dimpling of the skin or for an orange peeling of the nipples, also a flattening of the nipples. Now, doctors tell that some women are born with inverted nipples, and in them this is not a sign of any disease. The woman should also watch for a red, raw, moist condition of the nipple or for a bloody discharge from the nipple. Any of these signs, according to medical societies all over the world, could mean cancer and a threat to her life. A doctor should be seen immediately, yet millions of women in our affluent society delay. Medical science again emphasizes early discovery. This is essential, and in many breast cancers, this is possible through self-examination, as we presented later in this work. But it is not always the woman's fault that if she discovers a suspicious lump in the breast, that she cannot get proper attention. Our medical facilities in Britain and Canada and the United States are strained to breaking point.